Hey everyone, this is John Dickinson from motionworks.net, and in this quick tip, I'm going to show you some of my favorite shortcuts and features that are going to save you time when you're working in Sapphire's Effect Builder. To launch the Effect Builder from within After Effects, I'm going to click Edit Effect, and the first thing I want to touch on are the zoom shortcuts. To zoom in quickly, I can move my cursor over the preview window and press Ctrl Plus or Ctrl Minus to zoom out. That's Command on the Mac. If I move my cursor over the workspace, I can use the same shortcuts, Control Plus and Control Minus. To zoom to 100%, I press Control Zero. And the same with the preview. I also like to use a mouse, and I find the mouse wheel is great for zooming in and out. And while we're talking about the mouse, down here in the workspace, if I right click, I can get the hand grabber tool, and I can quickly reposition this node tree. I find this really useful. And when you're working in the workspace, you really want to stay organized. This is a fairly small node tree, but they can get quite complex. One way you can organize everything is by cleaning up all, and the keyboard shortcut is Control Shift L. But notice how in this particular case, that hasn't really given me an optimal result. It really depends on the structure that you've created. Just undo that. I personally prefer to select the nodes that I want to clean up and then press Control L, that's Command on the Mac, and that will clean up the selection. So Control Shift L cleans up everything, or Control L to clean up the selected nodes. Another often overlooked but really useful tool that you can use in the workspace are sticky notes, and you can choose it up here from the node menu. You can see here, Add Sticky Note. And this message might be for you to remember to do something, or to remember to change something, or it could be for another user to give them some clues on how to use this setup. For example, you might be a motion designer setting this up in After Effects and sharing this with an editor. And if that is the case, remember also that when you select a node, you can turn off the parameters that you don't want to see in the effect control panel in After Effects and in Premiere Pro. And something else that's often overlooked in Sapphire Builder is the handy animation curve feature. If I just select this node here, Lens Flare 2, come over to Scale Widths, and click this button here. This is for my animation settings. I can create animations from within Sapphire Effect Builder without setting keyframes. In this example, I'm going to create a look where the flare gets brighter and starts peaking from behind the lunar layer. So if I come over here and click this button here, and then I increase the slow in value and the slow out value to their maximum values, that'll give me a nice ease in and ease out over the length of the animation. So if I come back to the beginning, you can see we're not seeing that flare in front, and this is happening over the length of the clip. I can control the start time, the end time, and the mid time. And let's also do the same thing for the glow effect. Come over to brightness this time, and once again, slow in to the max, slow out to the max. Okay, so using those few shortcuts and features will allow you to get the most out of Sapphire Effect Builder. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click on the link in the description to download a free trial of Sapphire for After Effects and check out these great plugins for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all of the Boris Effects products.